Okay, so now in this video, we're going to focus on a type of bacterium. No, sorry, a type of virus that infects bacteria. And so when we look at this cell on my screen, this is a prokaryote, a bacterium that has one single circular chromosome. Okay, so when we talk about viruses, viruses are not living things. And the particular virus that we are going to talk about is called a bacteriophage. So this is a virus that infects bacteria, and it's made of two components. It has its protein coat, which is the blue part in this. Now, in this video, we're going to talk about how viruses infect prokaryotes or bacteria, because a bacterium is different than a eukaryotic, like mammal cell. And so here I see on my screen a bacteria that has a single circular chromosome, and we have a particular type of virus that infects these bacteria. Now, this virus looks like a little robot, but it's actually made of two parts, right? So it's made of protein as well as DNA, and this virus is called a bacteriophage. Sometimes for short, it's called a phage. So if you're ever reading like a prompt or just reading about biology and it references phages, like T1 or T2 phage, well, that is what they're talking about, a bacteriophage virus. Now, in my screen here, the red part is the DNA and the blue part is the protein. So when we look at how this bacteriophage infects the bacteria, we actually have two life cycles of this bacteriophage. So it can exist within a bacterium in like two options, basically. So our first one, we're going to talk about the lytic cycle. And so here we go. In the lytic cycle, what's going to happen is the phage will actually insert just its DNA into the host cell, which is the bacterium. So the protein coat itself does not actually enter the cell. There's a famous experiment from the 1950s with Hershey and Chase that confirmed this using radioactive sulfur and radioactive phosphorus. So if your teacher expects you to know that, I have a whole separate video on that subject. But anyway, so here you have this bacteriophage inserts its DNA, nucleic acid, into the bacterium, and it will actually guide like the breakdown, the chopping up or something of the host's circular chromosome. And within the cell, remember, like a virus, it like hijacks or celljacks or whatever that host cell, and it's going to use that cell's like ribosomes and enzymes and stuff to make copies of itself. So in the lytic cycle, that virus, the bacteriophage, reproduces, building more DNA, more protein coats, until it's like assembles and the little bacterium is full of this virus, causing the cell to burst. And if you recall from unit two, when a cell bursts, that's called cell lysis. Hence the name, the lytic cycle. So once that bacterium is so full of viruses, the cell will actually burst, and now the viruses can escape and go and infect other bacteria. So that is, this lytic cycle actually results in the death of the bacterium and the spreading of the virus. Now, sometimes environmental conditions may not be right, and the virus may not spread rapidly, but rather stay dormant. So the bacteriophage has another cycle called the lysogenic cycle. And in the lysogenic cycle, it will insert its DNA into the host, but this time the DNA actually like is, I know in my image here, it is like laying on top of the chromosome, but what I wanted to try to show you is that it actually becomes like part of it. So imagine you're playing Ring Around the Rosie and you're holding hands. Your hands represent the circular chromosome, and your friend comes and joins, and so you let go of hands and you join them into your circle. It's like that. Like it becomes part of that circular chromosome. I just wasn't able to show it in an animation. Okay, so it's incorporated within that circular chromosome, but it stays dormant. It's not, the genes are not being expressed. It's not producing, the ribosomes are not attaching. It's not producing viral proteins at this time. So now, as the bacterium goes through binary fission and reproduces, it's making copies during DNA replication of its own DNA, but at the same time, it's also replicating that section of viral DNA as well. So as that bacterial population undergoes exponential growth, you have like enormous amounts of that viral DNA in like, I don't know, thousands, millions of bacteria. Now there is some kind of, so here you can see the lysogenic phase as it reproduces. Now there are environmental signals. There's some kind of trigger that will actually cause that gene expression of that viral DNA to actually get like turned on, to actually start expressing those genes. And in that moment, it switches from the lysogenic cycle to the lytic cycle. And now, just like we learned a few minutes ago, now that virus, the bacteriophage, will begin reproducing within the bacterium, filling up, and bursting, and now spreading to the rest of the nearby bacteria. So when you look at the bacteriophage life, it has two cycles it can enter in. It could have the lysogenic cycle, which is a dormant cycle, which basically would increase the amount of bacteria that have the viral DNA. And in the lysogenic cycle, that is where those genes are actually being expressed, and the virus is multiplying within the bacterium, ultimately resulting in cell death because they burst out and go and infect other nearby cells. Okay, so that is the life of a bacteriophage and how they infect bacteria. Now, I will say, as far as the future of humanity and technology, as bacteria begin to develop antibiotic resistance to our antibiotics and our medications and stuff, using bacteriophages to target like superbugs to kill those bacteria might be an avenue that scientists take in the future for treating illness. So kind of cool stuff going on there. All right, good job.